Hey folks, Roland Martin here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Hey, today I'm going to show you my two favorite lures, the 5-inch Senko A and the Roland Martin Big Bass Spinnerbait. We're going to fish in Orange Grove Lake in Central Florida. Hey, good action. Stay tuned. Okay, that little cut right there looks good. I'm going to throw the spinnerbait over there. Just kind of slow roll it along. A little bit. I don't know what I got. I got a little one. Right in the middle of that cut, he hit. Now I have a trailer hook on here. Now this is just a little bitty bass, but this is just characteristic of what you got here. There's some big bass. That's a funny thing about Florida. You catch a variety of little pound and a half bass like this, and then you'll catch great big bass. This is something. Okay, now let's check another cast, because quite often there's more than one bass in a spot. Just throw it right back in there. Just come along. And now, what I said, I had a 1-2 punch, because what happens is the spinnerbait is a good first cast lure, but the Senko is a good backup lure. So the fact that I caught one in there, you always want to kind of back it up with the Senko. Throw it right in there. Okay, I always keep a high rod. Today's film is a lot of how-to stuff on fishing small waters. You notice I have my little heritage bass boat. It's a little 17-foot tracker marine boat, and it's a perfect boat for these small ponds like this. And what we are in an orange grove right now. There's one. I missed the fish. I just had a little bitty strike of some sort. I don't know what it was. Come on, Senko, I know you can do your trick. I like a really lightweight on a Senko. And the other thing I like to do with the lightweight is hold my rod up high so I can see the line. I'm using braid to a leader. So I have 20-pound test braided line and a 14-pound test fluorocarbon leader. That's all just the perfect complement for fishing this pond. It's not a whole lot of heavy brush and cover in here, so this is kind of gets by with the light hydrilla that we have and this little penny wart that we see on the bottom. Well, didn't get one. Okay, let's try another cast here. Now, one of the things that I've done on this little heritage bass boat is that I put a little micro power pole on, and this is the control of it. And in the back, I can let this power pole down. And what I'll do is I'll let it down right now. You notice it goes right down and stops on the bottom. There, I'm on the bottom right now. Okay, the power pole is down and I'm in a perfect spot. You know, just this little point is just the kind of place that you want to make a couple casts to start with a spinnerbait maybe. Just a nice cast right to that corner right there. And if that doesn't work, I'll throw the Senko. There's one. I knew it. There's one somewhere. Yes, sir. What we got, son? Yeah, look at that. Now, so often these bass are on the... That bass here is on the trailer hook. Look at this. I want to show you something. Trailer hooks are so important because that bass, even though he's just small, it's representative. I would have missed him if I hadn't had that trailer hook. And what that trailer hook is just so important to catching big fish. In tournament competition, we always run a trailer hook like this. It's so important. I'm gonna make one more cast. And back it up with a Senko. Can't beat a Senko. I'll show you the Senko rig again. This is a 1-2 punch. The spinnerbait Senko combination is just good no matter where you go. And this is just the perfect complement right here. This happens to be a 297 green pumpkin worm with a little 16th of an ounce screw-in weight. And that's a number 4-aught EWG, a new surgical hook steel. It's a special hook. It's really kind of cool. Okay, 20-pound braid. Now here's the thing about braid. I'm using spinning tackle. You might think, well, that's pretty light, but this spinning tackle is 20-pound braid. That's pretty stout. And with that, I've tied a 14-pound test fluorocarbon leader, and I've super glued the knot. I got a beautiful knot that's all super glued and strong, and that's a 14 pound test leader, and that's really, really the deal. Okay, now I'm gonna throw it out there right in the middle of that cut, see what happens. Okay, I made a nice long cast. I'm gonna hold my rod high. Now, the thing about braid, you can feel so much better with braid. You can feel the strike so much better. And by holding the rod high, you can watch the line. I'm a line watcher as well. So between looking for the twitch on the line and actually feeling the strike, holding the rod high is the way to go. Now, that's not the way to set the hook. Well, that's another whole ball game. Yeah, nothing happened there. You hear the pumps in the background. Actually, these reservoirs, I'm going to tell you the history of these reservoirs. This is a 4,000 acre orange grove, and the state allows them to use their own water resources, and they have to dedicate 10% of their land. So 400 acres of their property has to be in water retention like this. And this is just 100 acres of it, but there's actually 300 or 400 acres more of this water. So there's quite a few lakes out here. This is the biggest one. It's a little over 100 acres. This one is a nice one. Another one here. I'm gonna drop the power pole down. There's a little one. I don't know how big it is. It's a bass. Bass on a spinnerbait. Spinnerbait bass. I tell you, they load up on this one. I put a different spinnerbait on, a little bit smaller. I didn't put a trailer on this one, but I should have a trailer. I always have a trailer. It's a good idea to have a trailer hook anytime, but that one ate pretty good, so I didn't have a trailer hook on that one. Okay, let's see what happens here. Try another cast. Sometimes you're the second fish right here. Oh yeah, big one. Big one, big bass. Big bass on a worm. Big bass on a worm. I told you there was some big fish in here, folks. Big bass on a plastic worm. That's what it's all about. Yes, sir. I'll drop my power pole down. Yeah. Big bass on a plastic worm. A couple of nice fish. I told you that. You just have to just... They didn't get them on the spinnerbait so much, but look at this big bass here. That's a nice one here, son. This is what we're talking about. That's a nice one. Decent fish. Okay. What I did, I went a little heavier with the weight then. The winds got to blowing, so instead of staying with the 16th of an ounce, I went to a 3/8 of an ounce, and that's a decent fish. It's not real big, but that's just kind of representative of what's really here. So let me just show you the rig again. You know, you have to keep changing around as the conditions change. You have to change with it. And so what I did, I'm using that number 208. This is the watermelon red flake worm. Coming through the head about 3/8 of an inch and putting that, this happens to be a 3/0 hook, but a 4/0 will work as well. And then I have a small 1/8 of an ounce weight. That's 1/8 of an ounce lead weight, and I have a little bobber stop right here. I would slide the bobber stop down, and that's just 20 pound. That's just 20 pound braid, because I broke the other one off. So I figured, well, I need a little bit heavier line. But there's some big fish here. Just have to kind of get after them. Okay, get the drag adjusted just right. Okay, I'll try some more spinnerbait fishing. the spinnerbait, it's funny because I've done so well. Another one. I got another one. Another bass. Same spot. Look at that. Another big one. Another big bass. Another big bass. Same spot. Isn't that something? Whole school. That's a nice one. That's a nice one. Yeah, okay. Now we're talking. Same exact place. And the nice thing about this lake's not fished a lot. And you can look at these bass and see that they've never been caught before. There's no more hook marks in his mouth. Just a perfect deal. Okay, so that was a cool deal. Let me try that again. Oh, there's a good one. There's a good one. There's a nice one. That's a good one. That's a good one. That's a big one. That's a big one. Yes, sir. Senko's paying off. It's Senko time. Senko is paying off. I tell you, you can't hardly beat that Senko. I was kind of swimming that worm along, and boy, he came out and grabbed that thing good. So that's it makes me think I'm maybe working it too slow. Senko time. I kind of swam it along. We haven't caught a big one yet, but I'm telling you what, folks. Between that spinnerbait and this Senko, we'll catch a big fish today, I think. At least I'll show you some big fish on camera. Ones we've caught before, if nothing else. And big ones we caught in Missouri as well. Small. Hey, we're coming up on this pump though, folks. And now this pump is really something. I gotta tell you about this pump. That guy's skinny. Look how skinny he is. Ah, skinny fish. And I get this trailer hook out. Took it way down the stomach. Okay. Now there's a pump. You hear a pump running? Well, let's just tell you about the story of what happened. Bobby Urick, who owns Megastrike, we decided to make this Roland Martin Big Bass Spinnerbait, like what I'm throwing right now. This happens to be one of the original prototype ones, just like Bobby had that day. And this was like 6 years ago. And we came down to this pump, and we were actually standing on the bank. There's a levee there. And Bobby threw this white spinnerbait right here. He threw it into this pump, just where we're coming up on. And you're talking about a big bass. I'm going to show you some of the footage on that. It's just amazing.
Roland, he'll jump right in
there. Yeah. I got another one.
Got another one. You got a big one. Got a big old bass, huh?
Oh, that's a big one.
You got a big one. That's a big one there, Bobby. Go ahead and get down and get him. Bobby's got a big one. Woo. How big is your biggest bass?
8'3".
That's a big one. Look at the size of him. God. Look at the size of that one now.
Oh man. My God.
That's maybe your biggest bass. Look at that. Hey, we got maybe Bobby's
God.
Biggest bass. We got a scale. Just a second. Just a
second.
Let me get a scale.
Look at that boy. There you go.
Here,
just
turn him sideways. We're gonna find that scale.
Over 10. Look at that.
It's 11 pounds.
Oh, man.
Oh, man, what a fish.
Oh, what a fish.
Hey, We're going to take a picture. Hold that fish.
Well, folks, you have to admit, there's a lot of good action here on these Orange Grove Lakes, these small waters. Working them with that little Heritage bass boat, that's the way to go. Light spinning tackle is the way to fish a plastic worm. And of course, the backup, you know, having that big bass spinnerbait, there's always a chance of catching that big one. Hey, thanks for watching this YouTube channel. I'm an old school teacher at heart. I hope I can teach you a thing or two. That's what I'm trying to do. Passing it on. Hey, we'll see you again soon. Hit that likes button.